Hello.
Yes, sir. How you doing?
All right. How you doing?
Pretty good. This is Althea Robinson.
Yeah.
Do you know me?
No.
Well, somebody gave me your name, a fella downtown, and said y'all do landscape work.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Well, I got a boy that's needing a job. Do y'all need any help?
Oh, not right offhand. Not right at this present moment.
Yes, sir. Well, do y'all do, like, people's yards or mostly store, you know, like companies and stuff?
Yeah, we do residential and commercial.
Yes, mm-hmm. Well, he'll go.
Who am I speaking with?
Althea Robinson. Mm-hmm.
Right now, you know, I got a pretty good crew right now, and everybody's coming in and doing what they're supposed to.
Well, let me.
Do you live around here?
Well, no, I'm just moving to the area. And I was down, and a man gave me your number and said that you sometime hires people. And could I tell you, I got a son,
uh-huh.
And he got in some trouble here a few years ago.
Right.
And he's what you call incarcerated. You know, he's in jail.
Yeah, yeah.
And he gonna be getting out in about a month when it starts getting warm weather. He been in there 9 years.
Right.
And he just, you know, he just made a mistake like all of us do sometime, and he was really needing some help. He done straightened out and found religion and all that, and I believe he a good boy now, and was sure needing a chance.
Right. Well, I don't think I can do. I won't make no promises there. Let's just see. You say about another month before he gets out. Let's just see where I'm at within that time and see what I got, see if I have anything to offer him. I just don't want to tell you something and
do
your hopes up.
Yeah, I know. Well, I understand that. And another thing, I hate to say, I don't know how difficult it would be for him to do your kind of work,
uh-huh.
But he was, when he got into this trouble, they had a bad wreck when the police was chasing him, and he ain't got his right arm, and he only got like down to the elbow on the left arm.
Right.
Is there anything that kind of work you could do where he could just use his feet, you know?
I'll tell you, be honest with you, I don't have anything in right now in that.
Do y'all use them push lawnmowers?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, he could. He been in the penitentiary. He been mowing, and the way they do is they put some kind of a belt around him and strap that to the lawnmower, and he can push it like that, you know.
Right. Like I said, I won't make no promise. We just have to wait, and you know, until that time comes. I don't want to tell you yes, and I don't want to tell you no. I just rather wait. And
oh yes, sir. Well, I appreciate your kindness. Do y'all and I tell you, if he go to work for you, he used to have a real bad drinking problem. Y'all don't allow him to drink or nothing, do you?
No. No, I'm talking about fuzz drinking and drugs and all that. Whatever men do on his time, that's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but when he comes to work, you know, it's entirely different there.
Mm-hmm.
As long as he come in, he's sober the next morning. And everything, he can drink and do all he wants there.
All right. Do you drink yourself?
No, I have a beer every now and then. I'm not a drinker myself.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, look here, I sure do appreciate it. We kind of down and out. Do you think there was any way you could maybe let me have a few dollars to send him till he gets out?
No, I tell you what, I don't lend money.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm not in that fuzz financial stage. Yeah, I'm not in that type of stage to be lending and loaning money.
Yeah, well, he could pay you back about twice as much as you gave him.
Right, but I just if he's in a penitentiary right now, he's making about
15 cents an hour.
Yeah, I know they don't make too much in there. I know that.
Yeah.
Let's just wait till he get ready to get out of here or something, see where he's at, and we'll go from there.
All right, then. You have a good evening.